follow your passion. If you're interested in mechanics and if you have a slightly more arty side to your personality, materials is perfect for you. I'm involved primarily through two venues. One is the McMaster Steel Research Center. This includes in Canada, ArcelorMittal Dofasco, US Steel Canada, Tata Steel, includes several Japanese steel companies and several other companies in the United States. We are an integrated group, so we go all the way from making steel all the way through to the products end. And so we're doing projects on more environmentally friendly steel making. So we're doing basically the whole gambit across that. Another consortium that I'm involved in is the International Zinc Association, and in particular the Galvanized Auto Body Partnership. So this again is a global consortium dedicated to the science of zinc-coated steels for automotive applications.
I did 2 4-month co-ops. I was at Magna Powertrain of America at their driveline headquarters. I was in the prototyping department, and so they would have prototype transfer cases, which are four-wheel drive and all-wheel drive units in vehicles. And sometimes they would fail during testing or fail out in the field, and we would get the components back that broke and we would try to figure out what happened. So sometimes the wrong steel was used to make the component, or maybe it wasn't heat treated properly and it wasn't strong enough, or it was too strong, which made it too brittle for the job that we had to do. And so we kind of did some chemical tests and some microscopy, and we kind of tried to put the pieces together to tell the engineers what happened and what can we do to prevent the failure next time. We start a project in infancy and are really able to kind of direct it in the direction where it needs to go. The partnership that a graduate student has with their supervisor is one of true mentorship and very close learning, and the transfer of information when you have such a close relationship is unbelievable. There's a material for every application, and so it doesn't matter what your interest is, there's always work to be done in that area, and luckily in our department we have experts in everything.
So every material we look around, whether it's the case of alloys for automotive materials, whether photovoltaic materials, if you look at the memory capacity of a USB stick or the cell phones and so on, all these properties depend on exactly on the structural materials, whether you have a certain crystallographic packing, but you have certain specific atoms in the structure. So what we do in the group is trying to understand in details the structure of these materials so that we can understand ultimately all the properties of materials. In the research group, we work with many different companies, whether some projects are more industry-oriented, others are less industry-oriented. Many of the projects would be, for example, with companies working in the area of energy, fuel cells in particular, in the nuclear industry. We also have different companies that work in the semiconductor field, for example, in trying to develop antennas for cell phones, battery storage applications, so for cars, electric cars, that are very hot topic. We work very closely with major car manufacturers to try to develop better batteries.
My research is focusing on fuel cells, so that's a potential new car engine. They do exist already, except they're extremely expensive. It's about $60,000 just for a regular car. So they use hydrogen and oxygen to power the car rather than the conventional engine, and it's much cleaner. So this will hopefully cut down on our greenhouse gases and allow us to rely less on fossil fuels. So when I was deciding to attend grad school, I was looking at many different material science and engineering departments. I specifically chose McMaster because we have the Canadian Centre for Electron Microscopy. During my undergrad, I found characterization very interesting. So to be able to characterize material at the atomic scale was an ideal placement for me.